Ladies singing in Montpelier. You know the saying about the things not being over until the aforementioned singer belts out a tune.
Well, it took longer than expected, but the 2013 legislative session has now concluded. News Channel 5's David Charnes, just back from Montpelier, and filed this report.
The 180 lawmakers here in Montpelier are wrapping up their session for the night after a very long couple of months. Both the House and the Senate have adjourned for the night. Governor Peter Shumlin has spoken to both sides, congratulating them on their work this year.
The opportunity this session was keeping our focus on the kitchen table issues facing Vermonters after a painful recession.
Some of those pieces of legislation the governor is talking about include a budget package agreed to late Tuesday. The governor also noted the end-of-life bill passed Monday after months of debate, and benefits to school-aged children for lunches in school. Senate Pro Tem John Campbell says it all happened through teamwork.
It doesn't matter. The people that should win are Vermonters. And I think in the end, that's what's happened. Vermonters have won here because of the hard work we've done. And we did it collegially. We did it together.
One piece of legislation that did not make it through Tuesday night would have beefed up Vermont's campaign finance reform. Supporters say the House put a clause in it that would have limited how much a person could give to a super PAC. Representative Kurt Wright of Burlington says that made the bill subject to potential lawsuits.
So because of the failure of campaign finance reform, because of the poison pill that was put in, frankly, from the House, that's the way it's going to continue. There's going to continue to be a lack of transparency, and we are going to continue to not know where these contributions are going to come from till next year.
And with the 2013 session under their belt, some lawmakers seem to have some ideas about what they want to do next year already, with campaign finance reform heading the top of that list. In Montpelier tonight, I'm David Charnes, News Channel 5 Nightcast.